This week on Maker Update, motorized drinking, a Raspberry Pi RC tank, a trailer hitch table, fluorescent hexapods, bouncing pixels, LED album art, and solar blinking lights. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update. I hope you're all doing well and enjoying your summer. I've got a fun show for you, so let's get started with the project of the week. Masaharu Hirose, a doctoral student at the University of Tokyo, is studying the effect of how weight influences the way we taste liquids. And we're not just talking about whether the glass you're drinking from is light or heavy, wide or skinny. What he's made is a mechanical cup holder that can be programmed to shift its weight towards or away from the drinker as they drink. This little change apparently confuses your senses, creating the perception that the actual liquid you're drinking is heavier or lighter. It shifts how you perceive the strength of the flavor or qualities like viscosity or stickiness. In an interview with SIGGRAPH, Masaharu mentions he's using a Raspberry Pi to handle the interaction, but otherwise we have to guess at what's going on here. It looks to me like a relatively simple 3D printed frame with what I'm guessing is a stepper motor linear slider acting as the shifting weight. There's got to be an accelerometer in here somewhere too. Because you have to place your hand at the fulcrum of the thing, the influence of the weight moving back and forth has a big impact. Aside from the fact that I'm dying to try this, it also has me thinking of other ways we could interrupt or enhance eating with different gizmos. Maybe this is my natural next step from cocktail robotics. We should have a whole field of culinary enhancement robotics. Now that would be a tasty maker fare. More projects, check out this 3D printed RC Rover by MellowFire. It's an updated take on a 2015 design by Timmy Clark. This new version uses a Raspberry Pi Zero W and is designed to fit beefier high torque DC motors. But what's maybe the coolest part is that the Pi is set up as a wireless server that can connect up to an Xbox controller. You can find the code and the 3D files down in the description. I was also relieved to see that Laura Kampf has finally created a portable camping table she's happy with. There's been a lot of trial and error over the past year, but this design looks like a winner. The whole thing mounts to the hitch of her van, so there are no wobbly legs to worry about. But what I really like about it is how it can adjust up or down to allow the back door to open. Because once you have this thing attached, you probably aren't going to want to take it off again until you're done camping. It looks great, and it's a nice mix of metal and woodworking. It's also a cool example of how to prototype mechanical movements before committing them to the final design. This week, I also got hip to the artwork of Michael Candy, which I highly recommend. In particular, his 2018 piece called Cryptid. It's a giant walking hexapod with fluorescent tubes mounted to each leg. In the write-up I've linked to, there are some details on its construction. It runs off of 220 volts supplied by a cable that runs out the back. And there are some progress videos that show some of the actuators up close. And I was happy to learn that the code used to coordinate all the movements is actually adapted from an open source code developed for a small hexapod robot kit called Phoenix, created by Lynx Motion. I love thinking about how the code for smaller proof of concept machines can be scaled up to larger designs like this. On Instructables, I saw this Neopixel skirt by maketvee. Now I've seen my share of LED infused fashion, but this particular interaction was new to me. With a little jump, you get this bouncing ball animation that I think is just super fun. There are some other animations too, like meteors and flames, but the bouncy one is my favorite. On Reddit, Kyle Johnson talks about how he made this Spotify album art display. It uses an Adafruit 64x64 matrix display with the Raspberry Pi 3B Plus. The Pi is running a media server called Flash and Tash. With just a few lines of code, you can get it to send album art to the LED matrix. I kind of like the pixelated look, but I suspect some black diffusion acrylic would really put it over the top. You can find a link to the guide and the source code down in the description. Finally, check out this solar-powered blinky circuit by Okubo Heavy Industries. It's a freeform circuit that uses an ATtiny85, a capacitor, and some small surface mount LEDs. The whole thing is encased in clear acrylic. I just love how it's a completely self-contained, self-powered circuit, and unlike a lot of the other circuit sculpture stuff we see, the encasing here makes it durable enough to take out and show off. Now for some tools and tips. On the Cool Tools channel, I've got a review of screw removal pliers made by Engineer. This is the same company that makes my favorite solder sucker. These pliers are also a slam dunk, and just like the solder sucker, it's the kind of tool you want to have on hand before you need it. So check it out. Untested, Adam Savage offers up his guide to drill bits, from basic woodworking bits to masonry, step bits, spade bits, glass, acrylic. He covers a lot of ground in a quick and entertaining video. The back half of it, though, is a love letter to Forstner bits. I won't spoil it, but he makes a compelling case to pick up a set if you haven't already. On Hackaday, James McBennett has a self-paced Hackaday U course on designing shapes with complex geometry. You'll learn how to use Grasshopper 3D to create procedural designs that you can adjust with code. Whether you're into pushing the limits with CAD or creating your own mathematically inspired plotter art, it's a great free resource. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, check out this great search video by Lady Ada on Adafruit. If you've ever made a project that's powered by coin cell batteries, you've probably come face to face with how many different types of battery holders there are. Sometimes it's a struggle to find out which holder will work for your type of battery, what the tolerances are, and how it will connect to other components. Using the DigiKey product search, Lady Ada shows you some tips and tricks for finding just what you need. Check it out. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. Thinking back on that drink holder, what's a way that you can think of for mechanically optimizing or enhancing the eating experience? A big thanks to DigiKey Electronics for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.